My name is Anne and I have a story to tell. It starts with my husband, Jonathan, and I struggling to make ends meet. We were living paycheck to paycheck, barely making enough to cover our expenses. It was a constant source of stress and worry for us. We had dreams of starting our own business, but the financial strain prevented us from pursuing it. However, we refused to give up on our dreams and continued to work hard, hoping for a breakthrough. I don't know how we are going to pay the rent this month, Jonathan, I said to my husband, tears welling up in my eyes. We've been struggling for so long, and nothing seems to be getting better. I know, Anne, but we can't give up hope, Jonathan replied, trying to comfort me. We just have to keep working hard and trust that things will get better. But as the days turned into weeks and the weeks turned into months, our situation remained the same. We were barely getting by, and it seemed like our dreams of starting a business would always be out of reach. I don't know how much longer I can keep doing this, Jonathan said one night, his frustration palpable. We can't keep living like this forever. But we didn't give up. We continued to work hard and save every penny we could, hoping for a chance to turn our fortunes around. And eventually, that chance came in the form of a $1 million contract. My husband Jonathan and I were thrilled when he won the $1 million contract. It was a dream come true for us, I said to my friend Sarah over the phone. That's amazing, Anne. I'm so happy for you and Jonathan, Sarah replied. Yes, we couldn't believe it. And David, Jonathan's secretary, has been such a huge help. He's been working long hours with us to make sure everything runs smoothly, I said. That's great to hear. You're lucky to have someone like him on your team, Sarah said. I know, we really are. David's been a godsend. He even brought us lunch the other day and stayed late to help with some last-minute details. He's just been so supportive, I said. Well, it sounds like you have everything under control. I'm sure the contract will be a huge success, Sarah said. I hope so. It's a big responsibility, but Jonathan and I are ready for it, I said, feeling excited and a little nervous about what the future held. One day, as we were discussing the details of the contract in our living room, David walked in. Hey, I couldn't help but overhear. Congrats on the new contract, Jonathan. I'm here to assist in any way I can, David said with a smile. Thanks, David. We appreciate it, Jonathan replied, returning the smile. As we all sat and talked about the contract, David had some excellent ideas that we had not considered. You know, we could implement this strategy to maximize our profits, David suggested. That's a great idea, David. I think we should definitely look into that, Jonathan replied. I could see the genuine excitement in my husband's eyes as he discussed the possibilities of the new contract. David was a valuable asset to our team, and we were grateful to have him. Little did we know, our world was about to be turned upside down. One cool evening, I was relaxing in our home waiting for my husband to come home. Just as I was relaxing, my heart felt like it had been ripped from my chest as I saw the police car pull up to our home. The officers delivered the news that my beloved husband, Jonathan, had been found dead. I was inconsolable. As I tried to make sense of what had happened, David, Jonathan's secretary, came to offer his condolences. I can't believe this happened, he said, his voice filled with sympathy. Jonathan was a great man, and he will be missed. I nodded numbly, too lost in grief to respond. David offered to help me with the company in Jonathan's absence, and I was grateful for his support. As the days went by, I leaned on David more and more. He was always there for me, offering a kind word or a shoulder to cry on. You're not alone in this, Anne, he would say. I'll help you get through it. Looking back now, I realize how much I had come to rely on him. But at the time, I was grateful for any support I could get. Little did I know, David had a dark secret that he was hiding. I couldn't believe it. David, who had been so helpful and kind, was now the prime suspect in my husband's murder. As the investigation progressed, I began to feel more and more lost. One day, I received a call from the detective leading the investigation. "Mrs. Jonathan, we have reason to believe that David may have been involved in your husband's death," he said gravely. My heart sank. "What do you mean? What evidence do you have?" I asked, trying to hold back tears. "I can't go into details, but we found some incriminating evidence in David's office. We need to question him," the detective replied. I felt sick to my stomach. How could someone I had trusted so much do something so terrible? "Please find out the truth," I said, my voice barely above a whisper. "I will do everything in my power to get justice for your husband," the detective assured me. As I hung up the phone, I couldn't help but think about the life Jonathan and I had built together and how it was all taken away in an instant. I needed to find a way to move forward, but I didn't know how. I couldn't believe what I was hearing. David, the man who had been there for me throughout Jonathan's death, was now a prime suspect in the murder investigation. It was like my entire world was falling apart all over again. As I thought about it more, though, there were some things that didn't add up. David had always been supportive and kind to me, and I couldn't picture him as a killer. But the evidence seemed to be pointing in his direction, and I didn't know what to do. I decided to confront David and ask him about it. I didn't want to believe that he had done something so terrible, but I needed to hear the truth from him. When I met with him, he seemed nervous and uneasy. I asked him if he had anything to do with Jonathan's death, and he vehemently denied it. "I would never hurt Jonathan, Anne," he said. "He was like a brother to me. I'm just as devastated as you are about his death." But something in his eyes made me doubt his words. I couldn't shake the feeling that he was hiding something from me. I left the meeting feeling more confused and conflicted than ever before. After an investigation, it was revealed that David had killed Jonathan to gain access to the contract money. I was devastated to learn the truth about David. I couldn't believe that someone I had grown to trust and rely on had been capable of such a heinous act. As the investigation unfolded, the evidence against David continued to pile up. "I can't believe he did this," I said to the detective working on the case. "It's a shocking turn of events, Mrs. Jonathan," the detective replied. "But we will do everything in our power to bring justice to your husband's death." I felt a mix of anger and sadness as I thought about the future that Jonathan and I had planned. It was all gone now, thanks to David's greed. "How could he do this to us?" I asked, tears streaming down my face. "I'm afraid some people will do anything for money," the detective said, shaking his head. I couldn't believe it. My husband, the love of my life, was gone, and it was all because of David. The man who had been by our side for years, the man I had trusted and relied on, had betrayed us both in the worst way possible. It was a nightmare come true. David was later arrested and put in prison for a lifetime. It was a relief that justice had been served, but I was left to pick up the pieces of my life and my company. The thought of starting over without my husband was daunting, but I knew I had to be strong. It took time, but with the support of my family and friends, I was able to rebuild the company and find some semblance of normalcy in my life. I would never forget Jonathan, but I knew that he would want me to be happy and move on with my life. The whole experience taught me to be more cautious in whom I trust, and to always listen to my intuition. Reflecting on my journey, I have learned that life can take unexpected turns, and sometimes the people we trust the most can betray us. Losing Jonathan was a tragedy, but finding out the truth about David was even more devastating. However, I am grateful for the support of my friends and family who helped me through this dark time. Based on my experience, I have learned that trust is something that should be earned and not freely given. It's important to be cautious and take the time to get to know people before trusting them completely. In my case, I had trusted David, and he had used that trust to betray me and my husband. I learned the hard way that trusting someone blindly can have dire consequences. Therefore, it's important to pay attention to red flags, gut instincts, and behavior patterns. If something seems off or too good to be true, it's better to take a step back and reassess the situation. I hope my story can serve as a cautionary tale for others and help them avoid the pain and betrayal that comes with misplaced trust.